So I just woke up, checked my email first thing, and got a note from John. I get an extra 500 grams of carbs today. It's gonna be the greatest day of my life.
Fucking made it, guys. We fucking made it. 189 pounds and 15 ounces under, well, not all that under. I'm 1 ounce under the classic physique weight limit. 2 weeks out, which means the rest of the time of prep is going to be spent dialing me in and eating, fam. Look at what I got. Holy shit. So we have an egg white almond omelet. This is 4 egg whites with 3 ounces of lean ground beef, a little avocado. We got that nice salad. I like to saute in some fresh berries and tomatoes there. 90 fucking grams of oats with some unsweetened almond milk. Got some bananas in there. Two motherfucking Ezekiel muffins. One with peanut butter, one with jelly. Real motherfucking jelly. Essential amino acids. Get that protein up there. And then we got the GHU's sugar-free barbecue. Go to town on that motherfucker. Salt, finally. And, the Revive MD Digest Day, because I'm gonna need this motherfucker. Of course, it is Granite Essential Aminos rocking out. I'm gonna go eat.
Like, that was good. It was about 3 hours later. During that 3 hours, I took a nap and took a dump. First dump all week. It was good.
Oh God, I am so excited for this, guys. It is a plate of motherfucking pancakes. Real pancakes. They've got pumpkin, black cherries, syrup, peanut butter, banana in there. Oh man, I'm gonna go to town on these motherfuckers. This is my pre-workout meal. It's gonna be so sick. I fucking love this shit.
All right, guys. 2 hours after last meal, time to hit the gym. Now, usually, I do not wait 2 hours after my pre-workout meal. I usually try and make about an hour. However, that meal was a lot bigger than I'm used to, so I need a little time to digest. Need a little time to get right. So, now we've got the next helping hand. We have the Granite Premium pre-workout. I've been eating this straight, swear to God, because I have been so low energy lately. Obviously, with all these carbs, I'm jacked out of my mind, so we're just gonna do one scoop plus a little extra. This is pretty strong. It only has 200 mg of caffeine, but it also has theobromine and it has theacrine, both of which are nice complements to caffeine, so it gives you a nice energy boost without a terrible anxiety crash, which you guys know I get sometimes. In addition, you know, the arginine and citrulline, hugely helpful for a pump when you're in deficit. So it's a good product. Check it out, y'all. I am gonna go smash some motherfucking deadlifts. I'm gonna hit 600 for an AMRAP at 190 pounds. Let's see what I got. All right, we just rolled into the shop. I love saying that. The shop gym in Manassas, Virginia. It is time. I got a buzz going. We're gonna rock some deadlifts, guys. 600 AMRAP. I don't really have any expectations. I'm gonna keep my form perfect, tight. I'm not gonna have any injuries this close to the show. But with all these carbs, I'm feeling pretty fucking good. So I'm thinking 8 to 10. Do I have it in me? Let's go see. Guys, we just finished training. I'm not gonna lie, wasn't what I wanted. I went to 605. I put on the 55s, blah, blah. I only got 3 reps. Not happy about that. You know, my energy is through the roof. I guess the strength hasn't come back yet. But you know, that's okay. I am proud of myself for not risking injury. I am proud of myself for keeping that fucking ego in check. The ego is the hardest motherfucking thing for me. And it's not ego about how I look. It's ego about how much fucking weight I can lift. And that doesn't even matter right now. So I got to get that through my head. But hey, if that's my biggest challenge, I ain't doing too fucking bad.
Motherfucking post-workout meal. This is almost a box. It is not Cinnamon Toast Crunch. It is some generic ass cinnamon thing that has 0 grams of fat and is all like whole grain organic shit. So I'm down with that. It's good. It's not amazing, but it's good. One of the things I love about John's kind of style of dieting is that he doesn't do cheat meals. Cheat meals for me really fuck up my appetite. Because, you know, I'm not used to that type of food. So, but he does incorporate some, you know, a little bit tastier stuff day to day, so you don't get those huge cravings. Now, I know this doesn't look like much. This bowl is fucking enormous, though. That's a plate. That's the bowl. I am going to destroy this motherfucker. So, next meal. Look at the steam coming off that motherfucker. We've got 6 ounces of broiled chicken thighs, which are some of my favorites. A cup of white rice, some potatoes, some Brussels sprouts. I fucking love Brussels sprouts, y'all. Some avocado. This meal is a little higher in fat. I'm getting my added extra fats in this meal because usually I get 6 asparagus spears and 6 ounces of cod. So this is a massive fucking difference. I'm so excited. I'm going to eat again. All right, it's getting later, so a smaller meal now. We got some egg whites. We have 3 servings of cream of rice with some banana and some jelly. So let's fucking get after it.
All right, guys. That wraps up our full day of eating Refeed edition. After the first day, I gained about 2.5 pounds. I looked the fullest and tightest I ever have. After the second day, I gained about another 3.5 pounds or so. I gained a total of around 7.5 pounds, which is almost exactly what you would expect. You know, for every additional gram of carbohydrate that you take in, you can assume that you're going to gain about 4 grams of total weight due to glycogen retention. So if I took an additional 1,000 grams of carbohydrates, in theory, I'd gain about 8.5 additional pounds. And I actually gained 7.5, so pretty close. Shows my body's doing what it needs to do, responding in the way it should be responding, and from here on out, we'll just continue to dial in the details. Now, I did spill over a little bit after that second day. Spilling over is what happens when you take in too many carbs for your level of depletion for your body, and you end up retaining water under the skin instead of inside the muscle, and it makes you look flatter, more depleted, fatter even. So that's what happened. And so we took in a little bit too many grams of carbs, and so we're going to figure out over the next 10 days the exact ratio of macros that I need, the exact amount of food, the exact amount of calories, and I need to look at my absolute best when I step on stage for the first time on August 10th. At the Jay Cutler Classic in Richmond, Virginia. I hope you'll stay tuned. I hope no matter what, you continue to think strong and train hard.